Hi guys, it is Thursday, April 21st, 2016, and I just want to stop in here and say hi and hopefully give you all a little comfort. Last night we heard the news that Chyna, C-H-Y-N-A, I believe, who was a female wrestler, very famous, passed away. We found out last night at 45 or 46. I've seen both reports of both ages. And so, you know, everybody was like a lot of social media, rest in peace, and, you know, just didn't know a lot about her, but I did know about her and knew that she was very good at what she did and very famous. And so just pray for comfort over her family and all of her loved ones who were many fans of her loved ones. I pray for all of her fans and loved ones and family, friends, loved ones. Then this morning, we heard the news that Prince had died at 57. And so, you know, that hit a lot of people hard. And I'm just getting on here to hopefully, well, my thing is news and prayer anyway, but share a little comfort and just say a few comforting words. I don't even want to get into a lot of religion, or we don't call it religion here on the Christian side, but people would think of it as religious. But you know, when you think about people dying, you hope that they're saved. And I'm not the judge, so I don't know their hearts. I don't know where they were at as far as that was concerned, but hopefully they were, of course. But so, you know, just want to just say God touch those that loved Prince and Chyna and comfort your hearts. And, you know, before I forget it, I didn't do this for Prince or anything, but I didn't even know really too much about him. I knew about him, but I wasn't really into him like a lot of people are, but I bought some purple fingernail polish yesterday, and I don't know if you can see it or not. I put it on, though, for Prince today. I wasn't going to, and then I thought, you know, I'm gonna do that in honor of him, okay? I don't know a whole lot about him, but I know that a lot of people were really blessed by him and his music and his talent. So, I mean, you know, I did went over to YouTube, and I wanted to hear the song because I don't think I've ever really, I wasn't really into him and his music, actually. I know he was popular. Michael Jackson and him were kind of in a tie, I think. Maybe Michael Jackson more popular, but Prince was right there, flying alongside of him as far as popularity goes. And a lot of broken hearts today over him and over Chyna passing away. And really, both of them really kind of early in life. You just don't, you hate to see somebody. And I know there's people on here that are going to be critical of, well, you know, look at all the soldiers that die. And yeah, and of course, you know, we never forget the soldiers. We never forget regular people that die every day, okay? But, you know, there's nothing wrong with mourning and talking about, kindly about people that die, that are movie stars, that are popular. There's nothing wrong with that. I wish people would really get over that, separating them and then being so hateful that people mourn, you know, like Whitney Houston when she passed away, you know, in a bathtub, I guess, drowned of water or drugs or whatever, but, or drugs and alcohol, I don't even remember, but people were outraged at the fact that people loved her and were really grieving over her. And then a lot of people go, well, what about the soldiers? You know, we do mourn the soldiers too. So I pray that everybody would really get a grip on those kinds of things. And I think we can mourn them both. We can mourn them all. Okay. And anyway, I've longed for the day where I see pastors and ministers get on here and comfort the nation, the president, get on here and comfort the nation over things, not just this, but other things. We've kind of missed that with Barack Obama, because he's bound and determined to, I guess you call it, polarize groups of people, blacks against whites, and just on purpose, I believe, on purpose, just to tick people off, okay? That's my opinion. But anyway, Jesus said in Revelation 21:4, I believe, he will wipe all tears away, all tears, all mourning, all sorrow away one day when we get to heaven. We will not even remember the sorrow, you know. That's just such a hope, to put your hope in God, in Christ Jesus. And I just want to pray for God to comfort those people right now that are mourning over these deaths. And I pray for the nation and the world to come to Jesus and make sure that you have Jesus in your heart. It's just coming to him and praying. You know, if you don't believe him, if you don't believe that he died for your sins, he doesn't force you, because he gives mankind free will. The other day, I can't remember what it was over, but there was a child that asked something about, said the question, will he make us, referring to God. And I said, honey, no, he won't make you do anything. God doesn't make us do anything. We have free will, okay? And he's hoping and begging. He's not begging, but he's hoping that you'll come to him so that you'll have eternal life, and ask him to forgive you for your sins. It's just a simple coming into his, believing he's right there with you. I did it when I was 26, and I've never been disappointed. I mean, yeah, we all have trials and everything, but you never, never, ever, once you come to him with your heart and then confess Jesus as Lord, ask him into your heart, there's nothing ever to regret, okay? I've never heard anybody say they regret it. But anyway, I didn't want to get all into that, but I can't help it, you know, I can't help it. I mean, what if I had one last thing to say on earth myself? What would it be? Okay, it would be that people would come to know Jesus Christ so you could have eternal life. And Prince, apparently he was flying. Now, I don't know the exact story, but he was flying and he had to make an emergency stop the other day. And was entered into the hospital, and he said something about save your prayers, don't bother praying for a few days, save your prayers, don't, something like that, you know. And I'm just thinking, oh Lord, you know, life and death are in the power of the tongue, you know. God is not, you know, God wants us to pray, God, for each other. God wants us to pray, and that he's not like that. He doesn't think that would be a waste of people's breath or life or words or prayers. God does not think like that. God does not think like that, okay? He would have said, yeah, let's pray for Prince. Whatever the problem is, let's pray for him. So please, don't mock prayer. I know there's been some a lot of people get on and they go, well, it's too late this or too late that, and you know what, it's not going to keep me, stop me from praying. My mother died at 41, I believe, 41 or 42 or 40, of cancer. And I didn't know Jesus at the time, and I grieved and grieved and grieved for years, even after I met Jesus. And she would not have wanted me to grieve that long, to tell you the truth. I believe with all my heart, we wouldn't want our kids to grieve over us, and so that helped me get over it really quick. But forget what I was going to say, but anyway, just wanted you to know I love you and God loves you very much. And I pray for safety for you guys and health. It's really important to me that God keeps you safe, and with so much destruction going on out there, and that you have a good life in Him before and after, that you don't have to have a crisis in your life to come to Jesus, okay? That's not really how it works. That's not really His desire. Okay, so, but anyway, He does want you healed, and He wants you safe. He's the author of life, okay? He is the author of life. And if you ever hear of anybody saying, well, He lets you get sick to teach you a lesson, God's not like that, okay? Only time He ever allowed a thorn in the flesh was when somebody got to when He knew that maybe pride would be a part of somebody's life too much, and it would throw them off of being a humble person in Christ. And I know that firsthand. I've experienced that. I experience it to this day, actually. But it is His will for you to be healed and to be healthy, so and to be safe and to be saved and to have a good life, okay? He came to give you a good life, okay? And I'm going to stop it right there, and you have a good rest of the day, okay? Okay, and God comfort your hearts. In Jesus' name, amen.